Welcome to Q&A Software, the GST accounting software for your company. In this video, I will talk about the GST features in Q&A Firebird. Throughout this video, I will show you the GST settings and demonstrate a few transactions to see the GST effects. I will also show you the format of tax invoice that is compliant with custom requirements. Additionally, I will show you how to do bad debt relief and bad debt recovery, and also show you the steps of GST submission. You can get a copy of this article in the URL shown below. Before we begin, kindly enable GST 2015 in File, Module Selection. Make sure you have ticked the GST 2015 module. To view the list of preset GST tax codes, go to GST, GST Code. Click on the More button to view the list. Now click on the tax codes. Remember to set the GST posting account for each tax code according to chart of accounts. Now let's take a look at GST settings. Go to GST, GST setting. The GST effective date should be set to 1st of April 2015. Note that companies that have yearly turnover more than RM 5 million, they will have to set it to 1 month taxable period. If the company has yearly turnover less than RM 5 million, they will have to set it to 3 months taxable period. As you can see for this particular database, all the GST account has already been created. Newly created database comes with these GST accounts. For existing database users, users will have to firstly create all GST preset accounts and set the settings manually. Here is a summary of the accounts that you will have to create. Kindly ensure the accounts has been linked properly in GST settings. Now let's move on to the type of default posting in GST module. Kindly ensure that the default tax code are set to the following order. Now, I will show you the output tax GST setting in customer. Go to debtor, debtor maintenance or debtor accounts. Then go under GST tab. Now that I have set this customer to zero rated, it means that whenever you do any transactions entering with this debtor, it will automatically appear as ZR as the default tax code. Let me demonstrate to you once. Let's go to Sales, Invoice. I will issue this invoice to US Technology Limited. Now remember that we have previously set the default tax code of this customer to ZRE. So no matter which stock we select, the default tax code will be ZRE. As you can see, all items are now under ZRE tax code. Now, I will show you the GST compliant tax invoice. In the format field, select invoice with GST 2015. Now, let's preview it. This is how it looks like. The tax code in this tax invoice will always be zero rated regardless of stock items, since the export of standard rated items to overseas will be considered as zero rated supply. Now I will explain in more detail about the requirements of a source document for GST filing. The first is the issuing company name, address and registration number must be shown clearly. The word tax invoice must also be printed clearly. The tax invoice number and date must be shown as well. Customer name and address. The description of goods or services supplied. Total before tax, total GST amount, and total including GST. Finally, a tax invoice issued using Q&A accounting software will also show the breakdown of each GST category for easy reference. Let's say if you have not defined any tax code in the debtor maintenance, the system will check for the next tax code setting. Referring to the GST default setting earlier, the next default tax code is by stock item, so you will need to set the default tax code in stock maintenance and so on according to the default screen. For this stock item, eggs are categorized as ZRL output tax. And for white chicken, it is SR. Please take note that the tax code here is empty, and the system will automatically apply the default tax code priority. In this example, the default tax code is SR. Thus, if we leave it empty, it will be considered as SR. Now, I will demonstrate to you some sample transaction on input and output tax. For the first transaction, I'm going to purchase from Ali Manufacturing in Grand Bahad, and I'm going to buy fried chicken. Notice that the tax code TX6 is automatically applied to this item. Now let's view the journal of this transaction. Notice the GST input tax here. Now let's take a look at the GST detailed listing. Here is a transaction that we made just now. Now let's generate a GST OCHI return form. Go to GST, GST return form. Kindly be reminded that it is compulsory to fill in the name of authorized person, IC, and nationality. Here is where you see the total value of standard rated acquisition and total input tax. Now I will show you some sample transactions of GST output. Click on sales, invoices. In this invoice, I will sell 3 tray of eggs and 10 pieces of fried chicken to advanced trading. Take note of the tax code for each item. It reflects the correct tax code that we have set earlier. Here is the total GST amount. Now let's take a look at the journal for this transaction. Here is the GST output tax amount. You can always double check the transaction in GST detailed listing. Here are the items sold to advanced trading earlier. You can also track back the invoice by clicking into the record. Now I will show you the output tax in GST 03. All output tax will be under item number 5. Before making payment to custom, it is required to contrast between GST input tax and GST output tax. Due to GST, GST return form, generate journal. Here is the GST payable amount, the total output tax minus total input tax, and we will get the GST amount payable. Let's save this entry. Now let's create a payment voucher for the GST payment. Go to General Ledger, Payment Voucher.
This payment will be made payable to Jabatan Custom Diraja Malaysia using CIMB Bank. Select GST payable account. And the amount is 201 ringgit. Make sure the tax code is set to out of scope. And here's journal entry. Now we are going to talk about claiming bad debt relief from customs or GST paid when your customer fails to settle their debts within 6 months.
To create bad debt relief, go to GST, GST Advisor. Remember to check the GST period. Then click on Get Advice. Make sure you are in the Bad Debt Relief AR tab. Here are the list of bad debts. Select the records. Then click on Create button. Once created, the journals will appear under the History tab. Let's take a look at the journal. Users have an option where they can write off bad debt in debtor credit note transaction screen in a situation such as user already has confirmed that this debtor will not settle their debt anymore after some legal action and need to totally write off from the system. If user write off bad debt in debtor credit note screen, the outstanding amount for the particular invoice will not appear in the statement anymore. To totally write off the bad debt, go to Debtor, Credit Note. Select the debtor, then check the Bad Debt Relief checkbox. Next, click on the Relief Doc button. Select the documents. Then click on OK. Finally, click on the Save button. Now let's take a look at the GST return. Here you will see the bad debt relief amount. To recover back the bad debt relief transaction when we have received payment from debtor on a particular invoice in which we already classified as bad debt transaction previously, go to Journal, right-click, Bad Debts Recovery Customer. Select the record and click on OK. Now let's take a look at the GST return. And here is the bad debt recovered amount. Now I will talk on where to input MSIC code. Users should assign MSIC codes to GL accounts that affect the value of supplies and output tax. To check on which MSIC code you should use, kindly refer to www.statistics.gov.my for more information. Go to General Ledger and select on the particular account. Then fill in the major industry code. Now I will show you where MSIC code will reflect in the GST return form. Here is the breakdown of values of output tax based on MSIC codes. To generate the actual file that is to be uploaded to the Customs tab portal, go to GST, GST return form. Check the taxable period and remember to fill in the authorized person details. Then click on Tax File. System will prompt you on where to save the file. For now, I will put it on my desktop. And this is how it looks like. Now log in to the Customs tab portal and upload this tax file. Now let's save the tax return. Remember to change your status to submitted to log the posting period. Now we'll talk about generating the GAF file. Customs may request a GAF file to check on your filing. To generate the GAF file, go to GST, GST audit file. Select the period of the GAF file. Next, click on the inquiry button and you will be able to see all the data from this window. Here's the purchase data, the supply data, and the GL data. Click on OK button and select the location to save the GAF file. If you open the newly generated GAF file, it will look like this. Now you can send this GAF file to the customs. Thank you for watching.